Have you ever imagined being able to create anything you can think of right from your decks? That's the magic of 3D printing. Whether you are a hobbyist, a designer, or just someone who loves a thinker, 3D printing opens up the world of possibilities. And the best part, it's easier to get started than you might think. When I first started 3D printing, I was blown away by how quickly I could turn an idea into a physical object. It felt like having a superpower, and today I am excited to share that superpower with you. In this video, we will take a quick journey through the history of 3D printing, explore what it is, and break down the different types of 3D printers. By the end, you will have a solid understanding of how this amazing technology works and why this is changing the world. Did you know 3D printing has been around since 1980s? It all started with Chuckle, who invented stereolithography, a groundbreaking technology that laid the foundation of modern 3D printing. Through the 1990s, the new method like fused deposit modeling, FDM, and a selective laser sintering emerged, revolutionizing manufacturing. By the 2000s, projects like RepRap made 3D printing accessible to hobbyists. And by the 2010s, affordable 3D printers becomes a reality. Today, 3D printing continues to evolve with advancement in material, speed, and even applications like bioprinting. So, what exactly is 3D printing? Simply put, it's a process of creating physical object from a digital model by adding materials layer by layer. This allows for the creation of complex shapes like integrated internal channels or a lattice structure that nearly impossible to make with the traditional methods. Prototyping, medical, aerospace, construction, and hobbyist or creative art, 3D printing is transforming industries from 3D printed prosthetic to affordable housing. Its applications are reshaping how we design, build, and create. Now, let's explore the different types of 3D printers. To make this easier to understand, I will break it down into a simple tree diagram. FDM printers, the most common type. This melts plastic filament and extrudes it layer by layer to create objects. We will dive deeper into FDM in the upcoming chapters. Next, SLA printers, uses a laser to cure liquid resin into solid layers. They're known for their high precision and are also popular in desktop 3D printing. SLS printers, on the other hand, use a laser to fuse powder materials, making them ideal for durable and integrated components. DLP printers. DLP printers are similar to the SLA, but use a projector for even greater accuracy. And for metal parts, there is SLM, also known as laser powder bed fusion, which uses a high power laser to melt metal powder. Finally, polyjet technology jets layers of photopolymer droplets, curing them with a UV light. This allows for the incredibly fine details and even multi-material printing. Beyond this, 3D printing is used in a specialized field like construction, food production, aerospace, and even a biotech for creating organs and tissues. It's a technology that reshaping the industries from aerospace to medicine. But for now, we will focus on FDM 3D printers, the most widely used type. In the next chapter, we will explore how they work and why they are so popular. Ready to dive in? Let's go.